Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the NXEdge style 00 Quanta. Yes, been waiting for this for a while. It is... Man, it's a good looking figure. I gotta say, this thing looks great. It is one of my favorite. It's probably now my second favorite. Genesis Gaugar is probably gonna be my favorite forever. But this one is really good. They didn't seem to skimp. Well, I don't know what's going on with the clear part on mine. It's got a weird... I don't know, something going on. It's not the symbol. It's like something didn't sit properly in there. Like it's glue. I can't really tell. Kind of annoying. I love the metallic green all over it. Little gold. Just like the, they seem to be replacing yellow with gold. On the Gundams, at least. But there's a little bit, so it's not really a big deal. And, you got some clear on the legs. A lot of clear on the G and sword bits. Now, the one thing is, the sword bits are only painted on the one side. Which, I understand. It is a, like, they had to do skimp somewhere. And I'd rather have them skimp on these than on the actual body. And I really like the proportions. The feet aren't too big or anything. And it's got a standard articulation for this line. Double ball joint and neck. You have the ball joint shoulders, I have the hinge to go forward. The arms are ball jointed. Elbows can bend at one joint. Swivel wrist. You got the swivel waist. You got the ball jointed hips. Oops. you got a hinge knee. And a ball jointed ankle. Oops. You can do that. Then of course you have the G and shield. Which can, it's pegged onto the shoulder, not on the back. I know that's not accurate. And not a big deal to me. And you got a ball joint at the actual base. So you can have a forward, you can have a back. It works like it should, it's just that it's pegged on the shoulder, which, like I said, I don't really mind. Yeah, it just looks really good. I love the way this thing looks. And the white is nicely painted, it's nice and dark, not bleeding through. Which, you know, sometimes happens. I actually think... Is that arm white, or is it blue? It's hard to say. I think they might have painted it white. I can't tell. Maybe blue. Whatever. Yeah, it's a really cool looking figure. Now, the shield itself, it actually opens up. Which, have the GM drive, and it fires the beam emitter. I don't... that is the drive, or the beam... I can't remember. It's been a while since I really paid attention. But you can take off all of the sword bits. Which is really neat. They all come off. So, this thing is already pretty awesome. That it already puts like the Destiny and the Strike Freedom to shame. Because basically all the things it's supposed to do, guess what? It can pretty much do it. Even, you can take the GM drive and take the peg. Now the easiest way is to rotate it and then bring it down. Sometimes the blue part pops off. It'll pop right back on. And then you can ping this into the back for quantum burst mode. Oops. Yeah, like I said, it's a very tight joint. But you just... Oops, wrong way. Up like that. Ping that on. And yeah, quantum burst mode. So that's pretty neat. Now the sword bits are all properly sized. You got the little one, you got the big one, they have the... Oops, where is it? The really little one. So all three sizes are here. And you have the Aegean sword. 5, I think it is. Which you have sword mode, gun mode. It is pegged. It's one of those hexagon shapes, so you can actually kind of rotate it. I'm not sure if I'm damaging it by doing this, but you can without having to unplug it to switch modes. And I like the gunmetal they use on here. I thought they'd just keep it clear, but they didn't. Now this hand, you might notice, is sculpted to hold the Gian sword, and only the Gian sword. So it looks a little weird when it's not holding it, but it's not too bad. And you also have another open hand for the, whoopsie, for the left hand. Like that. So let's say he's controlling his sword bits. Now, speaking of the sword bits, First off, we have the stand, same as the other ones now. Once again, no bars sticking up to connect to another base going up, unfortunately, because they have a whole bunch of stuff in this kit, so they had to skimp somewhere. But they gotta stop doing that, because eventually you're gonna have no way to go up anymore. Like, you just gonna have to go out. Let's take, for example, if you bought the Quanta and the red frame, and only those two, you would have no way to stack them. You can only go out. Which, it might not be a big deal, but if you don't have a lot of space, it might be nice to be able to stack them, but you can't, because those two didn't come with any bars. Thankfully, I had the whole line so far, so I have plenty. Something else they included, a set of the necks, like the red frame had, and these green rings. Now, these green rings are used to connect the sword bits, so you can do the 00 Quantas, either the GM Burst Mode, or Quantum Burst Mode, or you can just have them kind of pegged on here, and like they're getting ready to fly forward. Like that. And I really like that. Very, very cool. But once again, make sure you do it the right way. You don't want the unpainted side up. So you just gotta be mindful of which one you're using. Once again, not a big deal. At least I don't think. Oops. And there we go. Now that is how I'm going to display it. That looks really cool. Takes up a lot of space, but I think it's worth it. Now another thing you get, which they actually show on the front of the box specifically, is an effect part. It is painted at the tip, so it kind of has a gradient effect going on. It goes from this blue to the clear. And basically, you take one of these necks, and it has a peg hole. And so now, it'll kind of look like the Quanta is, I guess, stabbing. You just slide that through, and like that. Which looks good with this. You can do with other kits, like the red frame. I guess, actually, that would look good with the... Oh, that would look good with Jessica Geiger, with the Jessica Driver. Yeah, I like that. Okay. So you can do that, or Bolting Driver. Yeah. Anyways, now the other thing is you have another blade. Now you can see this looks a little weird because, well, let's switch out the handle. So put the new one in. And once again, you can still switch it around. But this one, basically you take all the sword bits and put them together to make the GM paddle mode, at least that's what I call it. Because it definitely looks like a paddle. Alright, now I just gotta remember how to do this. It's been a while since I've combined his sword. I think it goes like that, and then this one here. Yeah, okay, I got it. Yeah, baby, I got it. Alright, and then just do the same thing on the other side. Got there. And they all hold together very nicely. Where the other pair went flying. There it is. Yeah. So, now we have the GM paddle. Now, unfortunately, you can't separate them to do the Buster mode. At least I haven't figured out how. And there's no peg to have this open up. But maybe there's a way. I don't know. And then you can have them hold it. And if I get the hand pegged in all the way, he actually supports the weight. For now. It might weaken over time. But yeah, you can totally do that. So, that's everything you get in the package. This is a lot. That's why there's no extra arm pieces for the stand. Because he has a ton. And let's compare him with the SD model kit. So you can see... Yeah, they're pretty good, but I really like the stylized version of the NXEdge style. And then, the 00 Arriver. Oops. Come on, Bandai, give us an Exia, complete the trio. You know you want to. So, that is the NXEdge Style Double Quanta. Really awesome figure. Like I said, it is my second favorite now. It has a crap ton of accessories. It looks really good. My only problem really is that whatever happened here might just be mine. And I wish I had the extra bars for the arms, but there's a reason it has so much stuff, so... It is still a pretty awesome figure. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.